En la English Speaking Union en Nueva York, siguen esforzándose en resolver el complicado proceso que supone aprender un idioma extranjero para poder acceder a la sociedad de habla inglesa.
The English Speaking Union is a non-profit membership organization. It was founded originally in Great Britain in 1918 and then 2 years later in the United States. And the idea was to bring together people from both countries using English, who used English as a first language, for friendship and cultural exchange and for education. We do projects and programs that have spun out of what we call the English in Action program between someone who speaks English as a first language and a newcomer to the country. They can be either immigrants to the country or people here on short-term assignments of one kind or another.
La English Speaking Union utiliza a neoyorquinos voluntarios que trabajan individualmente con los nuevos inmigrantes, ayudándoles a desarrollar el idioma inglés en el contexto de conversaciones informales.
They say more bang for the buck.
Exactly.
Now, is that an American, purely American, do you think? I mean, do they have basketball in Colombia?
Of course, but this is, you know, the quality of our basketball is terrible.
You would say to that person, that's really off base. I don't want you to say that again.
Oh, this is good. I can say it on a subway.
That's right.
I was taking some classes in an ordinary school, which I got so bored because they only teach you grammar and you study from their books. And I thought, so my friend said, why don't you just go to this English in Action and you can do one-to-one conversation.
The chief executive officer was really off base with his predictions about earnings.
Is there not? It was outside.
It means he was wrong.
Completely wrong.
The idea of being able to communicate with somebody and to communicate in ordinary, everyday English and to talk about idioms and all the expressions that are part of the English language, that's what's enjoyable.
Give me a compliment right now.
You are very well dressed.
That's a compliment. Now
but that's a bad sentence.
It isn't. I'm glad you detected that. It's not a great sentence.
No, it's not a great
sentence. You could have changed that easily.
Yes.
Can I say, please, I plead you to help me?
No. Please, I ask you or I beg you to help me. A person can use this word, say, please, do me a favor.
I'm the last of five children of Sicilian immigrants. I was born here. And we lived in Little Italy when it was inhabited by Italian immigrants. And I could see from my family, my parents especially, that the language was a constant problem for them. And it hindered them in trying to enjoy the benefits of living in New York. And so I could understand a little bit what some people are going through when they're here and they have trouble communicating with other people. So it's something I feel is important to do and I enjoy doing.
You're begging for something.